Hello and welcome to a short presentation video of the Sony DCD5 cassette tape recorder. This cassette recorder was made in the 1970s and the 1980s. This professional cassette recorder, and it is made by Sony. So, the follow-up model of this recorder is the Sony DCD5M, which has some improvements but is much the same than the Sony DCD5. Okay, now let's take a quick look to it. Here at first I'm open up the cassette compartment, and here we have two important switches. This switch is for Dolby noise reduction. This recorder has a Dolby B noise reduction system. And here we have the tape type select. You can select between normal, FECR or CR02 are selected automatically by this. Okay, here we have the eject button and the tape counter. It has two big VU meters, as you can see here, and 1 meter of these VU meters are also a bad meter, as you can see now, but my battery that I'm using is getting too flat, so okay. Yes, here we have the volume control. This volume control is for the internal loudspeaker or for headphones if you're using headphones. The quality of this internal loudspeaker here is not really good, but it is a really high quality recorder, and if you are using it with a hi-fi system, you can hear that this is really much quality. It also is heavy and looks like really stable, so it is a high quality massive thing. Okay, here at the front we have a switch for an audio limiter. I'm not sure if you can read this now, but this is for an audio limiter. With this you can limit the signal to prevent overdriving, which is a professional function, yes, that many professional recorders have. Here we have the level control for a record. The outside knob is for the left channel, and the inside knob is for the right channel. Okay. This recorder has a servo controlled capstan, which keeps the speed really constant. Now let's take a look at the connectors that this recorder has. Here at first we have a microphone input. These are normal microphone connectors, not XLR jacks. But there is a model, the Sony DCD5 Pro, available, which has two XLR jacks. And here we have line in and line out. Here we have normal RCA jacks for line in and for line out. And there, I'm not sure if you can see it, but there is a connector for an external power supply. It is for a 6 volt power supply. Okay. You can also use batteries, and at the moment I am using batteries, it's clear. Now let's do a short test recording. I'm connecting this microphone to the right channel. Here I've connected it, and now I'm switching on the record mode by pressing the record button, but first I have to put in a cassette, because it's a cassette recorder and it just can record on cassettes. So, resetting the tape counter and pressing the record button. As you can see, this light lights up, but it is not really bright because the batteries are really low. So, I hope I'm able now to record something. At first, I'm adjusting the level of the right input. Here you can see I can easily adjust it with this knob. And if it reaches the peak and goes over 0 dB, this big LED lights up, but at the moment you also cannot see it really bright because the batteries are going to flat. So now I'm overdriving it a bit, and if I switch on the auto limiter now, you can see it stops overdriving and limits the signal. Okay, now let's try the other channel. So now we are at the other channel, and you can see the other channel is also working. And now I'm starting the recording. Okay, now I'm recording on the Sony DCD5 cassette recorder, and I hope this will work because the batteries are really low, but I think it works. As you can see, the tape is running now. Here you can see it. And yes, after the recording you will hear that the internal loudspeaker has not really high quality, but as I have said it before, on a hi-fi system you will hear really high quality on the line output of this recorder. So now for a short test, I'm switching on the limiter now. Here you can see the limiter is also working on this channel. If I'm switching it off, you can see that this is absolutely overdriving at the moment. And yes, that's it for my short test recording. So now press stop for finish the recording. And now rewinding to the point of the start of my recording. It is not really fast at rewinding now because the batteries are going to flat. So now let's start.
You will hear that the internal loudspeaker has not really high quality, but as I have said it before, on a hi-fi system you will hear really high quality on the line output of this recorder.
It is really destroyed, you can hear. That is not because the quality of the loudspeaker is so bad. This is just because the batteries are really low and the amplifier is not working perfectly.
At this time, switching on the limiter now. Here you can see the limiter is also working on.
So that's it for my Sony DCD5 cassette tape recorder. A really high quality tape recorder, I think. And you can record a really high quality music in hi-fi quality. I've bought this recorder in eBay and I've got it really cheap because some things were damaged, and I had to repair some things, but now it's working perfectly. And yes, I can say really good recorder. And thanks for watching.